I'm not sure how to say this exactly because I don't want this to be misinterpreted, especially because my entire channel here is built on tutorials, but you need to stop watching React tutorials in 2024. And in this video, I'm going to tell you why. And also, by the way, if you haven't heard, I am launching Project React, which is a project-based React course this week. And if you want to learn more about it, it's the first link in the description. I'm going to first start by telling you a story. It's a story that changed literally the entire course of my React developer career. And I think that you're going to be able to relate to that because really, this affects all of us. When I first started learning React over 8 years ago, I had no course, no mentor, and not that many resources. All I had was simple tutorials and whatever else I could find by searching online. The whole reason why I decided to learn React in the first place was because it seemed like it had potential, that it could go somewhere in the future, which, as we've seen, it did. And honestly, it was also one of the easier options because it was using JavaScript, which I already knew a little bit of. So I decided to pick it up and start learning it. And like any developer would, I searched online for tutorials and guides to see what it was all about and how I could start building something with it. Now, at the time, React was still in its early stages, right? Class components were still the standard, and we didn't really have such a big community as we have it today. So tutorials and resources were a little harder to come by. I found some simple tutorials and then I started to watch them. I was learning about the basics, such as components, JSX, props, rendering, and all of that, and eventually also started building some simple apps with it. I built a to-do app, I built a movie list app, and other very simple projects. Now for a while, this was great. I was watching many tutorials, learning a little bit more with each video, and with the small projects that I was doing, I truly felt like I was learning and actually getting somewhere. Now, after a couple months of doing this, I eventually grew tired and honestly bored of tutorials and simple projects. I felt that I was ready for something more. I felt that I outgrew all of these tutorials. I wanted to tackle something that was bigger than a simple to-do app. So naturally, I started looking for a real React developer position. I applied to a bunch of companies, sent a ton of resumes, and even did a couple of interviews, and eventually, I actually managed to get a job, and I was really excited. I was excited to finally be able to put in practice everything that I'd learned on my own, because up until that point, the only thing that I did was tutorials and simple projects here and there. I had never worked on something that was bigger than one person. When I got that job, it was the first time that I was going to be working with a team of developers. It was the first time that I was going to see someone else's code that I had not written myself. And it was also the first time that I would see a real-world project made with React. Now, my first day, I remember it like it was yesterday, because unfortunately, it did not go well at all. As part of my onboarding, I was given access to the codebase, and I was told to spend the entire week getting familiar with it. Now, because I was entering the job at a junior level, I wasn't really expected to make any meaningful contributions during that first week. It would kind of be unreasonable to expect a junior to start being productive right away. So I pulled the repository, opened it up in VS Code, and what I saw, I have to tell you, left me in complete utter shock. I honestly had no idea what was going on. I opened up a couple files in the project, and although this was code that was written in React with JavaScript, I couldn't understand any of it. I remember having the app running locally on my machine and having the application on the browser, and also having the component that was rendering that specific page on the browser, and not being able to understand where the data on my screen was actually coming from. I saw the component, I saw the data, but I could not connect the two together. And it wasn't because I didn't know React, right? Like I knew this was React and I could understand that this was a React component that was rendering. But what I couldn't understand was how that component fit in the bigger context of the entire project. This was a project on a scale that honestly, I'd never seen before. That component wasn't rendering its own data. It was rendering data from another component that probably got that data from somewhere else that I had no idea about. There were so many files and folders that I honestly got so lost trying to figure out what was going on. Half of the files had things that I had never seen before, and the other half had so much complexity that I just couldn't understand it. I remember panicking on that first day and that first week. I genuinely thought that I wasn't qualified for this job and that they were going to fire me. Only later on did I realize that this is actually a thing that's called imposter syndrome. But how could this happen, right? Like that's what I asked myself. I had just spent months learning React. I watched all of those tutorials, did all those projects, and why was this so different? Why was I not able to understand the code that was sitting right in front of me? And that's when I realized. I realized that tutorials and those simple videos, those simple projects, don't actually prepare you for the real world. They only show you a very simplified picture of what it's really like to work with React in the real world. you only get a kind of slice that has been dumbed down to some basic primitives to make it simpler and easier for you to understand. And I mean, honestly, I don't blame them. That's how tutorials are supposed to be. They're supposed to be simple. They're supposed to be easy to understand because you're just starting out. You're just starting to learn about React. It would be unreasonable for them to be super difficult because that would be overwhelming. But on the other hand, when you eventually go and get that first job with React or that first contract, the projects that you end up working on will be nothing like those tutorials. You will go into it and you will feel overwhelmed with the code that's sitting right in front of you. And honestly, chances are, like me, you might feel like an imposter. Now, what happened to me back then is unfortunate, right? It's sad. I spent all that time and then I still felt like an imposter. And it's even more unfortunate that today, in 2024, this is still the case. So many of you watching this channel are in this exact situation, right? You're in tutorial hell. You're watching endless tutorial videos, doing simple projects, and you're feeling like you're learning something, when in reality, you're not learning that much. Right? And I mean, I say this as someone who's built this entire YouTube channel on tutorials. I'm not saying that tutorials are bad and that you shouldn't watch them. I'm just saying that they're not going to prepare you for the real world. Tutorials are only meant to get you started. They introduce the main concepts to you and give you enough knowledge to start building on your own. They aren't meant to be watched forever and to use as your only resource to learn. They're only meant as a starting point. To actually learn React properly, you have to take a different approach than just watching tutorials. And this is what this video is for. You have to take an approach that will map more closely with the reality of React in the real world. You need to start taking a project-based approach, which is learning by building projects. And the projects that you build have to go beyond simple to-do apps and movie lists. A project-based approach is going to teach you a lot more than any tutorial ever could. You're actually going to see and run into problems that you would find in a real-world project. And that is going to be the best way to get prepared for that first job or that first contract, because you are going to be working on real-world projects. Right? And actually, it's with that mindset that I make all of my videos on this channel, right? I have tutorial videos, but I also make alongside those videos, videos that show you a little bit as to how React looks like in the real world. Because that is the only way that you're actually going to learn it effectively, and the only way that you're going to feel confident in actually going to work with it in a real world. That first day at the job for me was really eye-opening. It made me realize that my entire approach at the time was totally wrong and that I should have done it differently. I shouldn't have spent all that time in tutorials, but rather, I should have spent much more time building something with it. Now, building projects is easier said than done, right? It's kind of hard to build a good React project, and it's also hard to know how to build it and how to make sure that you're doing it right, especially if you have no one telling you and guiding you along the way. And also, there aren't that many videos or resources that teach that specifically, unfortunately, which is what I'm trying to do with my channel. And that's why, also, this week, I'm launching Project React, which is a whole React course that is project-based that will teach you how to build real-world projects with React. It will actually show you how React looks like in the real world and actually prepare you for it. The course follows a project-based approach where you learn a little bit of theory in each module, and then you immediately go and apply it to the project in the course. You are building one big project throughout the entire course, and that project is exactly like one that you would find in the real world. The goal of the course is to prepare you for that first eventual day, to make you feel truly confident and be able to meaningfully contribute to the project that you're going to end up working on, to have seen how all the different pieces come together in a real-world project, to be able to do it yourself for your employer. I literally spent months on this course because I truly believe in it, and I truly believe that there's a lack in the market for something like this. It's the whole reason why I built this. I believe that this is the best course that you can take to become a true React developer who's actually capable of building projects. It is the course that I wish that I had when I was starting out, right? When I went for that first day at that first job. If I had this course back then, it would have saved me feeling like an imposter, and it would have actually made me ready to be able to work within that project. That's the whole reason why I built the course. Now, unfortunately, it's too late for me, right? But for you, this is just the beginning. And if you want to be a part of it, which I would really encourage, I'm launching it this week. You can sign up for the waitlist at coslin.solutions/projectreact, or you can click the first link in the description. Everything you need to know will be on that email on that waitlist, so that is the best place to be to get this course. You'll be one of the first ones to know when it actually comes out. And I truly hope that you will join me on this journey and take this leap for this course, because it is going to change your life and there is no other course like it. It is the only course that's going to make you a real React developer. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos just like this one, make sure to leave a big thumbs up to this video. You can also click here to subscribe, or you can click here to watch a different video of mine that YouTube seems to think that you're really going to enjoy. And with that being said, my name has been Darius Coslin. This is Coslin Solutions. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.